In a recent blog post, I featured some free clip art images that you could use for safety training. You can see those here. So if I scroll down, you can see here are some of the clip art images. And then what I did is I took the clip art image, like this one, for example, and I used that for my safety demo. And so I got a lot of questions about, well, how did I do that? How did I get it to look different? And how did I get these little icons? Let me show you how we do that. So first thing is we come into PowerPoint. So I've got my PowerPoint file here. And what I want to do is ungroup my clip art and do some customization. Now, I'm not necessarily a big fan of clip art, but sometimes that's what you're stuck with. So let's figure out how to use the clip art and make it work for us. So the clip art here is what we want to work with, and we want to get rid of all the colors and just focus on the eyepiece. Now, first thing I do is I duplicate the clip art image so that I have the original in case I need to go back and make some changes. And I'm going to ungroup it first so that we can work with the individual shapes within the clip art. So just right click, choose group, and ungroup. Now, sometimes you'll download clip art and you can't ungroup it. So people will ask, well, how do I know if I can group or ungroup the clip art? The easiest thing is to select group and ungroup. If you can't ungroup it, that means you can't. So we're going to go ahead and ungroup that. It's going to convert it first, and now we'll ungroup it one more time. And now we've got all the little individual shapes. And we're going to start by deleting the background. That's one of those things that make clip art look clip art. It's got all that kind of extra stuff on it. There's always like an extra background, so we're going to take that off as well. Now, this particular clip art image is actually one of the ones that can be a challenge working with. So I'm going to show you as we run into it. I'm going to go ahead. A couple things you can do is you can select these individual shapes. We want to de-emphasize the color, so we want to make them white. So you could fill them with white, or you can just delete them. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to click and delete the shape. So click, delete, click, delete, click, delete. Now I'm going to go ahead and delete this, and this actually exposes one of the problems. So when I go ahead and click to delete this blue part on the finger, you'll notice it's all black. And the other thing you'll notice, if I select the black, it's actually most of the image. So this is one of those clip art images that's a little bit more challenging to work with because the outline is actually one massive shape rather than a bunch of little shapes. So we're going to go backwards here. So in this case, I can't delete the finger color, so I'm just going to fill it with white. And I'm going to do the same thing here. We'll just fill that with white. We'll fill this area here with white. Oops. We'll fill this with white. And we'll fill this little shape here with white. And now we've got our clip art image looking more like an illustrated graphic. And then the only thing we need to do here is isolate the eyewear. So you can just go ahead and select the gray. And I'm going to fill it with yellow so it really stands out. And then I'm going to fill this here with yellow as well. So now what I've done is taken this clip art image and made it look more like an illustrated graphic, and I isolated just the specific safety equipment that I wanted to focus on. One of the other things when I'm working with clip art images, I'm always looking for things I can glean from it. So for example, these icons here all came from within the clip art image. So if we look at some of the clip art, let's see here, you'll notice here's a slippery when wet sign. Here's an eyewash sign. Here's a shower safety sign. Here's a little hazard thing. So what I did is I created one uniform shape, so they're all the same size. And then I isolated those little things. I pulled them out, and then I created my own little icon. Now, there is one image here that I didn't do that for, and that's this one here. You can see there's this little hazardous waste icon. So let's go ahead and create one. So I'm going to take this shape. We'll copy it. So I've got my uniform shape. I'm going to paste it here. So this is my shape. Now I'm going to take this clip art. I'm going to Control Shift G. That's going to ungroup it for me. And I only need this part. So I'm just going to select that. I'm going to hit Control G so that it's all together. And then I'm just going to drag it over here. And I'm going to size it up so it fits in here. So now I've got a little hazardous sign. And I can hit Control G to group it, and now I've got another icon, so I can hit Control C. We're going to copy that, and we'll just paste it in here in the corner. So now I've got another sign. Now, if I wanted to, I can make these a little smaller and add text in there. That would help. But the main thing here is that When you're working with clip art, ungroup it, take out the pieces you don't need. Sometimes just focusing on one particular thing, like in this case, we made everything white except for the safety equipment, that really comes in handy and then looks less clip arty. So hopefully that helps.